Okay, so we're commissioning yet another vehicle. Basically, there's a lot of checks that we have to do to make sure that the vehicle's fit to fly and serviceable. So that's been most of our morning and early afternoon. Once we're finished that, we're going to begin our multiple speeder ground test. So this is where we set up both systems, both integrated systems, and we do a full sweep of all flight profiles. We'll get two pilots in the room so that all of our operational teams here, and just pretty much confirm that the system's safe on the ground, as we always do, and then we'll take it to the air in the coming days flying, and yeah, that's where the real fun starts to happen.
Hi, my name is Brett Hill. I am the engineering project manager here at Alauda Aeronautics, and I'm helping to deliver with a wonderfully talented team the Airspeeder Mk3 for the EXA Series leading on to 2021 and 2022. 2 weeks ago now, we headed out for the first time and we successfully flew two speeders simultaneously in the air. In the last month, we've been really focused on delivering two speeders flying in the air simultaneously. Not only do you have to have two airworthy speeders, two trained pilots, but you also have to have the RF design of the system correct, because if you get interference between the control systems, it can be a disaster. We did a lot of testing on the ground, obviously before we got in the air, because at the end of the day, we don't ever fly something not knowing what's going to happen. So we always test, simulate to make sure that when we put it in the air, we know to the best of our abilities what's exactly going to happen. So the test went very well. What we predicted was going to happen, happened. So it was a massive achievement for the team. We've worked really diligently, really hard for a long time now. And so for them to be successful like this and to achieve this, you know, it's a great step on our road to racing, but also an achievement personally for each and every one of them.
Huge milestone, two speeders, two Mk 3s in the air at the same time. This is a breakthrough for us, and it's the beginning of racing, so this signifies a huge turning point for us.
There are a lot of flying car companies around the world. There are a lot of people building VTOLs, which is great. I mean, this is part of the industry that we're looking to accelerate. But it's pretty magic when you see two prototype aircraft like this in the air at the same time. That's kind of a game changer, really.
The hurdles that we've overcome to get here, I mean, there have been so many. Getting the technology working, getting the pilots trained up and licensed, getting the operational aspects of you know, just to get the whole crew out here weekend after weekend, day after day, has been tough. We're testing the drag race capability of the vehicle, of the pilots, of the whole crew. Everyone performed spectacularly, so couldn't be happier. Days like today really bring everyone together, and everyone's just happy and excited, and there's a lot of laughter. It's my birthday. This is the best birthday present ever.
Didn't realize it was going to kind of hit me so emotionally. It's like, been dreaming of this moment for so long, and now that we're getting so close to seeing racing, and when you actually see both of them in the air simultaneously, it starts to, you know, you get that really weird tingly feeling, you get butterflies. It's a special magic moment.
Lights on, all ACs are online, reading 58 volts.
Pitch back, nose up. Okay.
Confirm RPM.
Yeah, it's all good.
Well done, well done.
We've been on a road to develop our racing system, and that involves a communication system that'll cover the racing area. Network that we've been putting together, the communication system, we've been doing in conjunction with our principal telecommunications partner, which is Telstra Purple. And today we actually had our first infield test. So we did a ground test of our first Mk3 racing vehicle in the field with the network set up. So you can see behind me one of the trailers. We've got two of these out here. This is the main trailer. We've got a remote trailer, and they've basically set up a communications network across the entire testing area. Today we've got the vehicle out and we've been running checks to make sure that all the telemetry data is being successfully transmitted through the communications network, through the race data servers, and back to the vehicle. So we've achieved that today, which means that tomorrow we are now safe to fly and we will be operating the vehicle in the air.
From the perspective of the flight engineer, the new infrastructure has many advantages. One of the main ones being that we get significantly less dropouts when multiple vehicles are on the network. This is beneficial in many ways. One of the main ones being that it increases our safety overall for the system, as well as increasing reliability and resolution in the data that we can capture on that ground control station. Engineering is very much an iterative process, and through this iteration of the design, we're pushing towards making the vehicle safer and more reliable, both through the Telstra partnership with the network that we've developed and also with the architectural changes that we've made to the vehicle. This allows us to be more confident moving towards racing in the future.
So this system is really the foundation and the building block of our collision avoidance system, which then enables us to have multiple vehicles racing in close confines. So this is what this unit really provides, and without it, we wouldn't be able to have that exciting racing that we're hoping to put together in the near future.
Massive sort of achievement this weekend, and then 2 weeks, it's hopefully another massive achievement. When you're working as hard as the engineers at Alauda are doing, it helps keep morale up, because you know, long days, it can get tiring, but when you have these big wins like we did this weekend, and hopefully on into the future, it really does bond the team together. And so we've got a pretty tight team here at Alauda, and something to be very proud of, I think.